Start your day with remembrance of Allah. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيد الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الصلاة والسلام عليك يا رسول الله الصلاة والسلام عليك يا حبيب الله الصلاة والسلام عليك يا نبي الله وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا نور الله رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي اللهم افتح علينا حكمتك وانشر علينا رحمتك يا ذا الجلال والإكرام Oh Allah Azza wa Jal, open the doors of knowledge and wisdom for us. Have mercy on us, O the one who is the most honorable, the most gracious. بلغ العلا بكماله كشف الدجا بجماله حسنت جميع خصاله صلوا عليه وآله May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala pardon us our major and minor sins. May Allah azza wa jalla grant us the blessings of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in this world as well as in the hereafter. Nonetheless, dear viewers, alhamdulillah, today our topic of discussion will be with regards to the blessings of Hazrat Sayyidina Ali Karramallahu Ta'ala Wajhahul Kareem, who is the father of Hazrat Sayyidina Imam Hassan Hussein Ridwanullahi Ta'ala Alayhim Ajma'in, the blessed husband of Fatima Az-Zahra Radiyallahu Ta'ala Anha. Let's inshallah Azza wa Jalla listen to the virtues and blessings of Durood-e Pak. Thereafter we shall listen to a Naat-e Paak sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and thereafter we shall move towards our discussion inshallah. It has been mentioned in a book called Abi Kauthar with relation to the virtues and blessings of reciting Durood and sending Salat ala Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that once a beggar had begged before some non-believers. Those people did not give this beggar anything that he asked or begged for, and they directed him towards Hazrat Sayyidina Ali radiyallahu an and said to him that, why don't you go and ask this person, for he will surely grant you something. The niyyah and intention was to make a joke out of the situation. For when Hazrat Sayyidina Ali radiyallahu an would not be able to give this beggar anything, then they would laugh. Allahu Akbar. When this beggar went and begged before Mawla Ali radiyallahu an, who had witnessed this entire situation, smilingly he asked him to open his fist and recited one durood upon Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and blew in the empty palms of this beggar, asked him to close his fist tight, and advised him to only open his hands when he reaches before those non-believers. Allahu Akbar. So this beggar once again goes back to those non-believers with his fist closed, and as he goes before them and opened his so-called empty fist and hand, there was a golden coin in the hands of this beggar. Seeing this miracle and karamat that Hazrat Sayyidina Ali radiallahu an only blew and made dum in the empty hands of this beggar, but by reciting Durood-e Paak, the blessings of which was that there was a golden coin in the hands of this beggar, many of those non-believers embraced Islam instantly. Seeing this amazing, marvelous karamat of Sayyidina Ali radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. May Allah Azza wa Jalla, for the sake of Hazrat Sayyidina Ali radiyallahu an, forgive us our major and minor sins and grant us the blessings of reciting and sending salat, salutations and salams upon the most exalted and celebrated Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Huzur aisa karam mujh pe kaash ho jaye. Huzur aisa karam mujh pe kaash ho jaye. Mera wazifa durood o salam ho jaye. Momino padhte raho tum apne aqa par durood, hai farishto ka wazifa as-salatu was-salam. Jab farishte qabr mein jalwa dikhaye aapka, ho zuba par pyare aqa as-salatu was-salam. Sallu ala al-habib sallallahu ala Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Salatun wa salaman alayka ya sayyidi ya Rasulullah wa sallam alayka ya sayyidi ya Nabi Allah. In today's episode, we are going to be discussing the
miraculous wonders of Sayyidina Ali radiallahu anhu, the blessings of this great personality, his blessed biography, and his Mubarak Seerah is what we are going to be studying, inshallah. So, without any further delay, dear viewers, for those who have just joined us, yes, you are watching The Early Echo, please stay locked with Madani Channel and watch this program from beginning to end for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Right now, we are going to be listening to a Mubarak and beautiful Nati Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So stay tuned with Madani Channel. Sallu ala al-Habib sallallahu ala Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
Na koi aap jaisa tha, na koi aap jaisa hai. Koi Yusuf se poochhe Mustafa ka husn kaisa hai. Ae jalwa-e jaanana, ae jalwa-e jaanana. Aqa, tu shama-e risalat hai, aalam tera parwana. Wo kehte na kehte kuch wo kar ae jalwa-e jaanana ae jalwa-e jaanana
sallu ala al-habib sallallahu ala muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What a beautiful kalam. And may Allah Azza wa Jalla bless us through the blessings of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Nothing in this world is fruitful without the love of our beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Dear viewers, Alhamdulillah, Thumma Alhamdulillah. Welcome back to those who are watching this program, and for those who have just joined in right now, you are watching The Early Echo. It has been mentioned in a narration that once Hazrat Sayyidina Ali radiallahu anh was at the Blessed Kaaba with his two Mubarak children, Hasnain Kareemain, Ridwanullahi ta'ala alayhim ajma'een. And he saw a person that attracted him, so he asked for that person to be presented to him. That man came crawling on the ground. Mawla Ali radiallahu anh asked him, what is the matter? He says, well, I am paralyzed, I cannot walk. My body is not functional. Hazrat Sayyidina Ali radiallahu anhu then asked him, what is the matter and how did this happen to you? So he says, Ya Sayyidi, I was an open sinner. I used to commit many sins. My father would advise me. My father would support me. My father would encourage me to give up sinning, but I was very stubborn. And one day upon his advising me, my anger had got to me to the extent that way I ended up beating my father. I hit him so hard that my father, with tears in his eyes, set out to the Holy Kaaba. And whilst he presented himself here at the Holy Kaaba, he cursed me. And his curse was accepted, and immediately and instantly I became paralyzed. This paralysis affected me to the extent that I then could not move even an inch. I have no movement in my hands and in my body. Allahu Akbar. Having said this, he says, And then when my father saw my pity condition, I cried to him, "Oh my father, whatever it is, I am your son, you cursed me, and I am in this situation right now. What do I do and where do I go from here? Main kahan jaun? Kiske paas rahun? Akhir mein aap hi ka to bachcha hoon." Allahu Akbar. Fatherly love and muhabba made him feel sorry for his son. So he says, "Ya Amirul Mu'mineen." And then my father told me, "Oh my son, don't worry. I will pray at the very same place where I cursed you. I will pray for your well-being. I will ask Allah Azza wa Jalla to forgive you as well, for I have now forgiven you for doing what you had done to me." So he says, my father and I set out for Makkah al-Mukarramah. We were on our way here to the Holy Kaaba when the camel began to run between the rocks and the mountains. And as it stumbled, my father had fallen from the camel and he hit his head on a rock and instantly he passed away. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. My father passed away in this situation. Somehow or the other, I managed to bring myself here with the help of others. And now that I'm here, I'm crying. I'm asking my Allah, I'm asking my Rabb to forgive me and give me back my health. I cannot operate, I cannot function, I cannot work like this. So he was crying for his sins. He says, I'm crying for my sins I committed. I'm asking my Rabb to forgive me because my father had forgiven me. Hadith Sayyidina Ali radiallahu anhu said to him, "Really, son? If this is the case that your father had forgiven you, then let's pray together. Let's pray together in the court of Allah Azza wa Jalla, for He is the Almighty and He will definitely forgive you as well. He is the most merciful Rabb." Having said this, Hadith Ali radiallahu anhu performed few raka'at of salah. After offering few raka'at and units of namaz, nafil salah, he then made dua in the court of Allah Azza wa Jalla. And after making dua, he turned towards this person and he said to him, "Oh young man, qum, stand." And immediately as that man stood, he was able to walk and move. Allahu Akbar. As if nothing happened to him. It seemed as if he was never paralyzed. He was never ill. He was never affected with paralysis. Allahu Akbar. This is one of the karamats of Hazrat Sayyidina Ali radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. Ye dua Allah ki bargah mein hum karte hain, aap bhi shamil ho jayein. Allahu Akbar. The poet says so beautifully, Ali ke waaste suraj ko phirne wale, Ali ke waaste suraj ko phirne wale, ishara kar de ke mera bhi kaam ho jaye, ishara kar do ke mera bhi kaam ho jaye. Ameen bi jahin nabiyil ameen sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sallu ala al-habib sallallahu ala muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The name of this great personality whose karamat we have just heard right now, dear viewers, is Hazrat Sayyidina Ali bin Abi Talib radiyallahu an. He is the lion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and he was born in Makkah al-Mukarramah. Hazrat Fatima bint Asad radiyallahu ta'ala named Hazrat Ali radiyallahu an after his father Haydar, whereas his own father given him the name of Ali radiyallahu an. Subhanallah. From amongst his titles granted by the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam is Asadullah, and some of his other famous titles is Murtada and Karrar. Murtada means the chosen one, whereas Karrar means the one who strikes repeatedly. Sher-e-Khuda means the lion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. These are some of the titles of Hadhrat Ali radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. Allahu Akbar. And remember, Hadhrat Ali radiyallahu an is the paternal cousin of our beloved Nabi sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. The kunya of Hadhrat Ali radiyallahu an is Abul Hasan, since he is the father of Imam Hassan, and Imam Hassan is the eldest son of Hazrat Ali radiallahu anhu. So his appellation is Abul Hassan and Abu Turab. This great personality was born 30 years after Ammul Fil. What is Ammul Fil? It is when the wicked King Abraha attacked the Holy Kaaba with a huge troop of elephants. Allah Azza wa Jalla destroyed Abraha and his elephants. 30 years later, when the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was 30 years of age, that is when Hazrat Sayyidina Ali radiyallahu anhu was born, dear viewers and listeners of Madini channel. And furthermore, he was born on the 13th of Rajabul Rajab Sharif, on a Friday, inside the Holy Kaaba. Allahu Akbar. And his mother's name is Fatima bint Asad radiyallahu ta'ala anha. He was only 10 years old when he came into the fold of Islam, and he radiyallahu anhu was raised in the household of the Holy Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wasallam. He remained active in supporting the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam and promoting the religion of Islam throughout his life till his last breath. And he radiyallahu anhu had a distinguished reputation because of being amongst the Muhajireen Awwaleen and the Ashra Mubashara, possessed many other remarkable attributes as well, dear viewers. Being Ashra Mubashara, meaning amongst those 10 Sahaba who had been granted the Basharat and glad tidings of Jannah. Allahu Akbar. He had many other beautiful and amazing qualities, dear viewers. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us for the sake of Hazrat Ali radiyallahu an. Furthermore, if you study the biography of Hazrat Ali radiyallahu an, you would learn that he took part in many battles with exceptional bravery, dear viewers. Allahu Akbar. In the battle of Badr, in the battle of Uhud, in the battle of Khandaq, he radiyallahu anhu took part, and he sent many renowned and brave non-Muslim, meaning kuffar, into the hell through the strikes of his very famous sword known as Zulfiqar. Allahu Akbar. After the martyrdom of the third Khalifa in Islam, Hazrat Sayyidina Uthman Ghani radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, the Muhajireen and Ansar pledged allegiance into the hands of Hazrat Sayyidina Ali radiyallahu anhu, and taken him to be the Amirul Mu'mineen, Khalifatul Muslimin. Allahu Akbar. And being the commander and leader of the believers, he radiyallahu anhu held this office of Khilafat 4 years, 8 months, and 9 days. On the 17th or 19th of Ramadan al-Kareem, he radiyallahu anhu was seriously wounded by a Khariji's violent assassination attempt, which proved fatal. And he radiyallahu anhu on the 21st of Ramadan al-Mubarak passed away as a shaheed. May Allah Azza wa Jalla grant us the blessings of Hazrat Ali radiyallahu anhu. So as you just heard, in a nutshell, some amazing qualities and some aspects of his blessed life from his birth till his Mubarak demise. There are different riwayat with relation to when he was attacked by the Kharijis, but as I just mentioned, according to the most authentic narrations, on the 17th or 19th of Ramadan he was attacked, whereas he became a shaheed on the 21st of Ramadan al-Mubarak. Allahu Akbar. Sayyidi Ala Hazrat Rahmatullahi Ta'ala Ali, in his famous Salatu Salam Mustafa Jani Rahmat Bilako Salam, he composes this beautiful couplet. He says, Asl nasl safa wajh wasl khuda, asl nasl safa wajh wasl khuda, asl nasl safa wajh wasl khuda, bab fazl vilayat pe lakho salam, bab fazl vilayat pe lakho salam. Asl nasl safa, Ali al-Murtada radiyallahu an, is the very origin and foundation of the pure and pious Saadat. Allahu Akbar. Wajhe wasle khuda. And he radiallahu an is the mediator for becoming wasil billah, being close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is the reason for a person to become close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is the medium and the wasila. Allahu Akbar. And then in the next couplet he says, Babe fazle vilayat pe lakho salam. And he radiallahu an is the portal from where virtues of vilayah come from. May there be millions of salutations upon this great personality. Allahu Akbar. He is the portal from where vilayat is distributed, dear viewers. And this is of Madini channel. Kya baat hai Madine ki. May Allah Azza wa Jalla forgive us for his sake through his sadqa in wasila jameela. Let's learn more about Hadith Sayyidina Ali radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, dear viewers. How was he granted the title Abu Turab? It's a very beautiful narration. It has been mentioned that Sayyidina Sahal bin Sa'ad radiyallahu anhu narrated in Sahih al-Bukhari volume number 1 that one day Hadith Ali radiyallahu anhu went to his blessed wife Fatima Zahra radiyallahu anha, and after going to his home, he left his home and went to the masjid. After some time, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam came, and he goes straight to the house of Hazrat Ali radiallahu an, asking his blessed daughter with regards to the whereabouts of Hazrat Ali radiallahu an. She mentioned, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he came in some time back and he perhaps has left for the masjid. Rasulullah sallallahu then went into the masjid and seen him laying on the ground at one side. And because of laying on the ground, there was dust and sand on his back. Allahu Akbar. Rasulullah ﷺ then went close to him and with his mubarak and affectionate hands began to dust his back. Allahu Akbar. As Rasulullah ﷺ began to dust his back, he says, Qum ya Aba Turab. Allahu Akbar. This title became so beloved to Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu since that day. Allahu Akbar. That then he became famous with this title, Abu Turab. Allahu Akbar. May Allah Azza wa Jalla grant us ishqe Ali radiallahu an. With regards to this laqab and this title, Allah says, Usne laqab khak shahnshah se paya. Usne laqab khak shahnshah se paya. Jo Haider Karrar ke maula hai hamara. Jo Haider Karrar ke maula hai hamara. Jo Haider Karrar ke maula hai hamara. Allahu Akbar. It is a very famous saying about Ali radiallahu anhu that when he would start reciting the Quran, the speed of his recitation is that as he would put his first foot into the first stirrup of his horse, he would begin reciting the Quran. And by the time he puts his second foot into the second stirrup of the horse, as he rides the horse, he would complete one entire Quran, dear viewers and listeners of Madani channel. Allahu Akbar. In Shawahidun Nubuwa, page number 212, you will find this beautiful incident with regards to reciting the Quran. We're not speaking about his knowledge as yet. Allahu Akbar. We are speaking about his taqwa and piety right now. His knowledge is a different aspect altogether with regards to his ilm, with his thinking skills and ability and power. We will discuss that inshallah very shortly. This is his recitation of the Holy Quran Pak. When he would give charity in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with his pure heart, even that charity that's given through the hands of Ali radiallahu an is recorded in the Holy Quran Pak. Allah Azza wa Jalla says beautifully, الَّذِينَ يُنفِقُونَ أَمْوَالَهُمْ بِاللَّيْلِ وَالنَّهَارِ سِرًّا وَعَلَانِيَةً فَلَهُمْ أَجْرُهُمْ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ وَلَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. Those who give their money in charity in night and day, secretly and openly, they have their reward with their Rabb. They neither have any fear, no sorrow. So When you look up this verse in the tafsir of the Quran Pak, you will find that Sayyid Muhammad Na'imuddin Murad Abadi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi has explained in tafsir Khazainul Irfan, according to one of the opinions, this verse was revealed for Hazrat Sayyidina Ali radiyallahu anhu. Allahu Akbar. And subhanallah, the reason for this was because once he possessed only 4 silver coins. He had nothing else to donate in the path of Allah. And he wanted to give something as lillah, for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal, but he had nothing besides these 4 coins. So he gave 1 coin to the poor in the night, he gave 1 in the day, he gave 1 secretly, and then he gave the last one openly. These 4 coins he given with such pure niyat and intention. Allah Azza wa Jalla revealed this verse in the Holy Quran Pak. Dear viewers and listeners of Madani channel, there is so many lessons to be learnt only from this one incident. But before I move further, I want to elaborate a little further on this point to make our viewers of Madani channel understand how could we leave out, you know, the lessons learned from this beautiful style and tariqah taught by Mawla Ali radiyallahu anhu. How dignified are the righteous servants of Allah Azza wa Jalla. So compare our giving, our donations, and comparison to our pious predecessors, the Sahaba Ikram. Our problem is simple as this, that if our name isn't taken by the Imam Sahib of the Masjid, that so and so who has a certain business has sponsored the ceiling of the Masjid, has sponsored the carpets of the Masjid, has sponsored the food for today, has sponsored the mic system, has done this and done that, then people take offense. My name hasn't been taken. Sometimes shaitan takes advantage of this. Besides you making your business famous, shaitan may put waswasa in the mind of a person. Shaitan may make him lose the reward and thawab which he may have earned because he done that for the pleasure of Allah Azza wa Jal. But then when shaitan plays with a person, he puts pride into the heart of a person. A person then has ostentation. He begins to show off about the things he has done. This is what shaitan does. People's names aren't taken, they take offense to that. How could you forget my name? Allahu Akbar. They want to be called the so-called tycoons of the society. They want people to call them as he is a lani and the rich person of the society. Allahu Akbar. This sort of attitude takes us nowhere, dear viewers, except for destruction, except for being destroyed in terms of one's deeds. They will be destroyed and nothing to be gained, because Allah Azza wa Jalla has spoken about us reminding the favors that we do for people. You either hurt the feelings of the person by reminding him over and again, I borrowed you this pants, I given you this kurta. You remind the person, I bought you the vehicle, I helped you buy a house and home for yourself, I have done this and I have done that. May Allah Azza wa Jalla grant us the hands which always gives and never take from people. Rather, we only do for the pleasure of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Holy Quran Pak about us not nullifying our charity. Do not nullify. Do not wash away the good deeds which you just earned. What is the verse of the Quran Pak? Allah Pak says, الَّذِينَ يُنفِقُونَ أَمْوَالَهُمْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ ثُمَّ لَا يُتْبِعُونَ مَا أَنفَقُوا مَنَّا وَلَا أَذَلَّهُمْ أَجْرُهُمْ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ. Those who spend their money in the path of Allah, then after spending neither boast or favors conferred no hurt. Allahu Akbar. Their reward is with their Lord. So people who neither boast or remind others about the favors, what will happen to that person? Brother and sister, your reward is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whoever you helped, aapne jiski bhi madad ki hai, agar aapne Allah ki riza ke liye kiya hai, to uska thawab, uska ajr Allah kiya hai. On the day of qiyamah in this world and in the hereafter, you will receive this reward, providing that you do not hurt the next person. Khair, Allahu Akbar. Har amal jo hum kare bas Allah ke waaste rahe. Every deed that we perform in this world should only be for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Have you not heard about the incident Mawla Ali radiyallahu an was on top of a person having his sword on the neck of this person during a battle, and this person out of anger spat on the Mubarak face of Ali radiyallahu an And immediately he set him free, he let him go. This person got up, dusted himself and said, now what happened? I provoked you. Why wouldn't you chop me? Why wouldn't you kill me? Hazrat Ali radiallahu anhu said to him so beautifully that for the first time that you were under my sword, your neck was under my sword, I would have done that for the pleasure of Allah Azza wa Jalla. But the moment you spat on my face, you provoked my desires. And now if I had done anything to you, it would have been for my own nafs and desire and not for the pleasure of Allah Azza wa Jalla. Since I have only fought with you for the sake of La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah, my intention is not to hurt you for no reason. There is a reason behind this fight and argument. Allahu Akbar. But now that you spat on my face, the reason of hurting you then would have become my personal grudge and anger for spitting on my face. Allahu Akbar. I do not fight for my own pleasure. I only fight for the pleasure of Allah Azza wa Jalla. This is Hazrat Ali radiyallahu anhu. Dua kare Allah ki bargah mein.
Mera har amal bas tere waaste ho. Mera har amal bas tere waaste ho. Kar ikhlas aisa ata ya ilahi, kar ikhlas aisa ata ya ilahi.
Sallu ala al-habib sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Dear viewers and listeners of Madani channel, humne isse qabl ye suna tha ki jab aap ghode par sawar hote hain, to sawar hone se qabl, before he rides the horse, before he sits upon his horse, when his leg goes into the first stirrup, he starts the Quran, and by the time he places his foot Mubarak into the second stirrup of the horse, he completes one Quran. If this is his speed of reciting the Quran, we don't know, this is his karamat. How fast can one recite? Kya ye aqal mein aane wali baat hai? Dear viewers and listeners of Madani channel, this is actually the karamat of Hazrat Ali radiyallahu an. When people make time for Allah, then Allah Azza wa Jal makes time for them in this way, that they are able to perform such lengthy ibadat within such short span of time, which is beyond our comprehension. You and I cannot comprehend with this, but it is the fact and reality. It is possible, dear viewers. Allahu Akbar. If that is the speed of his recitation, then what do you think will be his knowledge about the Holy Quran Pak? He says himself, radiallahu an, that Allah Azza wa Jal has blessed me with such knowledge. I swear by Allah, I know every verse of the Holy Quran, that when and where it was revealed. Allahu Akbar. Verily, my Rabb Allah Azza wa Jalla has bestowed a heart upon me to comprehend and a tongue to question. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. He says, Allah Azza wa Jalla has given me a heart to comprehend and a tongue to question. And then he also says in another narration that Allah has granted me such knowledge about Suratul Fatiha alone, that if I had to write the commentary and explanation of Suratul Fatiha, I could load 70 camels with only the registers of Suratul Fatiha. Allah. 70 camels, dear viewers. I could load them with only the exercises to say the commentary and the explanation of Suratul Fatiha. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Furthermore, with regards to his knowledge and ilm, we always heard narrations, Ana Madinatul Ilmi wa Aliyun Babuha. Further on, there are many other narrations as well with relation to this, aside from the fact that Nabi Prophet ﷺ said, I am the city of knowledge, and Ali radiallahu anhu is the door to that city. Allahu Akbar. We would learn more ahadith with regards to his knowledge, inshallah azza wa jal. But I just want to bring to your attention that being such a great personality of his time, even Hazrat Sayyidina Umar Farooq radiyallahu an, who set it up the system of judges in the Islamic world. There were no judges before this. A person who will decide the matter of the case. This came into existence in the time of Hazrat Sayyidina Umar Farooq radiyallahu an. But it has been mentioned that they would always have Hazrat Ali radiallahu anhu to also be mawjood and present when they would make a decision, because of his skills of deciding matters, of making decisions, to the extent that many Sahaba ikram, Hazrat Abdullah bin Abbas radiallahu anhu says, many other companions says that the people, the residents of Medina, will have their matters decided by Ali radiallahu anhu. For all cases, people would look forward coming to Mawla Ali radiallahu anhu to decide their matters, because Allah azza wa jalla had blessed him with this skills that he would find solutions to huge problems instantly. There are so many books which have been written with regards to this, subhanallah, how he would do this, subhanallah. It's really, really amazing, dear viewers and listeners of Madani channel. So alhamdulillah, loving Hazrat Ali radiallahu anhu means we should love all the companions ridwanullahi ta'ala alayhim ajma'in. Not having muhabba and love for other companions and only Ali radiallahu anhu is a matter and problem, and this is what I will be explaining to the viewers inshallah just after we listen to this Madani Guldasta. Guldasta ki taraf jaate hain, usse sunte hain, and when we do come back inshallah, we are going to be discussing the matter of loving the Sahaba Ikram, Siddiq Akbar radiallahu anhu, Umar Farooq, Uthman Ghani radiallahu anhu, and Mawla Ali karramallahu ta'ala wajhahul kareem. Stay tuned and locked with Madani channel. Sallu ala al-habib sallallahu ala Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam.
May Allah bless you in the world.
Sallu ala al-habib sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wasallam. Sayyidina Anas radiyallahu ta'ala anhu narrated a hadith that one day the beloved and blessed Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alihi wasallam ordered his companions radiallahu anhum to fast, and then said, none of you is to do iftar until I permit you. So the people fasted. In the evening, the companions came individually to the noble Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam and said, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, I have fasted today, so please give me permission to do iftar. The noble Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam would allow them to do iftar. One of the companions radiallahu anhu came and said, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, in my house there are two girls who have also fasted today. They feel shyness in coming here. Please allow them to do iftar. The Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam turned his face away from him. He asked for the second time, but the blessed Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam turned his head away from him again. When he asked for the third time, the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, revealing the news of ghaib, those two girls have not fasted. How can they say that they have fasted? They have been eating the flesh of people all day long. Go and tell them to vomit if they have fasted. The companions radiallahu anhum went home and told them what the noble Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam had said. When they vomited, blood and pieces of flesh came out of their mouths. The companion radiallahu anhu returned to the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam and told him about the girl's condition. He sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam said, I swear by the one in whose omnipotence my life is, if it had remained in their stomachs, fire would have eaten them, because they both backbitted each other. Sallu ala al-habib sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam.
May Allah bless you in the world.
Sallu ala al-habib sallallahu ala Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Welcome back, alhamdulillah. For those who just joined us, you are watching the Early Echo, alhamdulillah. And this is from South Africa. The effects of the tongue's misuse was the Madani Guldasta we were listening to, alhamdulillah. These three effects, may Allah save us from and grant us the clean tongue. Ki hum jab bhi zaban se baat karein to achha hi baat karein, aur Allah ki rizahi ke liye kalam karein. Dear viewers and listeners of Madani channel, alhamdulillah, Hazrat Ali, the Mubarak and blessed husband of Bibi Fatima Zahra radiallahu anha, he says that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam once speaking to me said, you are the example of Hazrat Sayyiduna Nabi Isa alayhi salam, against whom the Jews had grudge. You are the example of Hazrat Sayyiduna Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, because with Isa alayhi salam, the Jews had grudge. They even slandered his Mubarak and blessed mother. But when the Christians loved him, they elevated him to such a high status which he actually didn't even deserve. Allahu Akbar. Hazrat Ali radiallahu anhu then further says now, when Nabi Pak Sallam told me this about Isa alayhi salatu wasalam and compared me to him alayhi salam, then he says that two kinds of people will be devastated on account of me. Number one, the ones crossing the limits in intense devotion, love with me, and they will add those characteristics to me that I don't possess. And number two are those people bearing grudges against me. They will provoke them to slander me. Allahu Akbar. I just felt it was important for us to know that in Musnad Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal, this hadith, this narration has been quoted. Allahu Akbar. So the thing is, dear viewers and listeners of Madani Channel, that Hazrat Sayyidina Isa alayhi salatu wasalam is of course Allah's Mubarak and blessed Nabi. When the Jews had grudge against him, then they had really grudges against him to the extent that they slandered his mother as well. And when the Christians loved him, then they committed kufr by granting him and giving him those attributes which Nabi Pak says he didn't even deserve. And likewise with Ali radiallahu an, as he says for himself, that people will love me and attach so much of love and devotion to this, that then they will add those characteristics which I didn't even deserve. And then the other group of people that will slander me, and these people will provoke them to do even more. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. So what does grudge against Hazrat Sayyidina Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu mean? It means that love for Ali radiallahu anhu is the canal of faith. No doubt. Love for him is the path and the tariqah and the way to having complete faith and iman. To strengthen one's iman and faith. He is the Ahlul Bayt. He is the from Panjatane Park. And it is of course terrible to cross the limits in love either way. But grudge against Ali radiallahu anhu is really haram and absolutely forbidden. And sometimes it is even kufr and unbelief. Dear viewers and listeners of Madani Channel, together with that, we need to understand the ranking of the Sahaba Ikram. We should understand the different levels and what are the statuses. It is extremely important. We cut off other companions, whereas Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam have never cut them off. And rather, when the Holy Rasul sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wasallam prays, he says, Ana Madinatul Ilmi wa Abu Bakrin Asasuha. Allahu Akbar. He says that I am the city of knowledge. Wa Abu Bakrin Asasuha, and Abu Bakr is the foundation. Wa Umaru Hitanuha, and Hazrat Umar are the walls. Well, Uthman Ghani is the roof. Wa Aliyun Babuha, and Hazrat Ali radiallahu an is the door to this city. Ana Madinatul Ilm. I am the city of knowledge. Abu Bakr is the foundation of this city. Hazrat Umar radiallahu an is the walls of the city. Uthman Ghani is the roof of the city. And Ali radiallahu an is the door of the city. The Holy Prophet ﷺ kept them together. The Holy Prophet ﷺ taught us how to respect them and understand the different levels of superiority above each another. What is the system of Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah? This is extremely important for us to understand, because remember, Hazrat Ali radiallahu an, his love has a demand. O Ashiqi Rasul sallam, O Ashiqs of Ahlul Bayt, the love of Mawla Ali has a demand. What is the demand of his love? It is mentioned clearly by him himself. He says, Allahu Akbar, after the Holy Prophet sallam, Abu Bakr and Umar are better than all. And he says, who is saying this? Hazrat Ali says, love for me and hatred for Abu Bakr and Umar can never gather in the heart of a true believer. Allahu Akbar. Nahin, ek dil mein, agar ye dil huzur ke liye hai, agar ye mu'min ka qalb ho, musalman ka dil ho, to ek aise dil mein, one side you have love for me, but you have nafrat and grudge for Abu Bakr and Hazrat Sayyidina Umar and Uthman Ghani radiyallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in, or any other companion, for example. This is not possible. Allahu Akbar. So Hazrat Mawla Ali radiyallahu ta'ala anhu's love has that demand, dear viewers and listeners of Madini Channel. Subhanallah, how amazing and how beautiful is this. Let's listen to what Hazrat Sayyidina Umar Farooq radiallahu ta'ala anhu has mentioned with regards to the distinctions of Hazrat Ali radiallahu anhu. He says that Ali radiallahu anhu holds three distinctions, and even if one of them were given to me, it would be more beloved to me than even red camels. Who is saying this? The second Khalifa in Islam, Umar Farooq radiallahu anhu, says, even if one of these three distinctions were given to me, it would be more beloved to me, more dear to me than even red camels. And what are those distinctions? Of course, red camels were of very high value in those days. Allahu Akbar. So the example of the red camels, which was the demand of the time, was used in this narration. So he says the first distinction is that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam married his blessed daughter Fatima al-Zahra to Hazrat Sayyidina Ali karamallahu ta'ala wajhahul kareem. One of the biggest distinctions, that he got to marry the daughter of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Number two, he says his Mubarak residency, his Mubarak house, was attached to the house of Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wasallam. And what was halal for him inside there was his exclusivity. Allahu Akbar. It was his speciality. And number three is that the flag of Islam was given to him in the Battle of Khaybar. These amazing blessings is only given to Hazrat Sayyidina Ali karramallahu ta'ala wajhahul kareem. How amazing is this? Now, understanding the category of the Sahaba ikram mentioned in Bukhari Shariat, Allahu Akbar, Sayyidina Ali al-Murtada radiyallahu ta'ala, that he radiyallahu anhu was held in high esteem by Amir al-Mu'mineen Sayyidina Umar Farooq radiyallahu anhu. But it does not mean that Hazrat Sayyidina Ali surpassed Hazrat Umar Farooq in ranking of eminence. Now, to understand what I just mentioned now, it's very important for us to pay attention. Sadr al-Shariyah, Badr al-Tariqah, Allama, Mawlana, Mufti Muhammad Amjad al-Azmi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayh, in the book of Fiqh, has mentioned that with respect to superiority and ranking according to the Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah, the school of thought, is that all companions of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whether superior or inferior, and there is no inferior among them, of course, are destined for Jannah. Whether the names came at the top or whether the names came below, though there is no one who is inferior amongst the Sahaba, all of them are superior. Allahu Akbar. They are greater than all human beings in this world because they saw the Holy Rasul ﷺ with their naked eye. So of course they are superior than all the other ummatis. So Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wasallam Sahaba have great and high ranking, dear viewers. After the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, the first and greatest human being on this earth, Afdalul Bashar, the greatest human being after all the Prophets alayhi salatu wasalam, is Hazrat Sayyidina Siddiqui Akbar radiyallahu anhu. Day after Umar Farooq radiyallahu anhu. Day after Uthman Ghani radiyallahu anhu. Day after Mawla Ali karamallahu ta'ala wajhahul kareem, are superior in that order to all the creatures of Allah Azza wa Jal, whether they are jinns or human beings or angels. Furthermore, dear viewers and listeners of Madani Channel, whosoever considers Hazrat Ali radiallahu anhu as superior to Sayyidina Siddiq Akbar or Farooq Azam is a deviant having corrupt beliefs. The aqidah and the belief of Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah is the very same sequence of Khilafat. Siddiqui Akbar, Umar Farooq, Uthman Ghani, and then Mawla Ali radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. Whosoever considers Sayyidina Ali as superior to Siddiqui Akbar or Umar Farooq radiyallahu anhu is actually a deviant and he is not on the correct path. The superiority of rank after the above mentioned four righteous Khalifs of Islam is for the remaining members of Ashra-i Mubashara. Allahu Akbar. After them, after the names I just mentioned, then comes the maqam and the status of those 10 individuals who were granted the basharat in this very dunya of Jannat, known as Ashra-i Mubashara, followed by Hasnain Kareemain, then Ashab-e Badr, those who partook in the Battle of Badr, and then Ashab-e Baytul Ridwan, those who took submission and allegiance in the hands of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and all these are absolutely Jannati. categorical jannati. They are definitely jannatis. They will enter paradise, inshallah. So superior here means, listen to this as well, means being more respectable and honorable in the court of Allah Azza wa Jal. The same also stands for bearing abundance rewards as well. So this is the actual truth, dear viewers and listeners of Madani channel. And this is the fine line for us to save our iman and our faith, that we should love and respect all these sahaba ikram and understand the ranking which has come from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is the mansha, it is how Allah Azza wa Jal has made this possible. Allahu Akbar, without any arguments, without any fight, without any quarrels, these khilafat were given with understanding, with respect for one another. Allahu Akbar. And with regards to Ashra Mubashara, I was just going to mention that these are those 10 individuals who were given the glad tidings of Jannah. What are the names? For the sake of barakah and blessings, we would like to go through their names as well. Subhanallah, Hazrat Sayyidina Abdurrahman bin Auf radiyallahu ta'ala has reported that Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wasallam has said, Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman, Ali, Hazrat Sayyidina Talha, Hazrat Sayyidina Zubair, Abdurrahman bin Auf, Hazrat Sayyidina Sa'ad bin Abi Waqqas radiyallahu an, Hazrat Sayyidina Sa'id bin Zayd, Hazrat Sayyidina Ubada bin Jarrah radiyallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in. All these names that we mentioned now are jannatis, and they are the Ashra Mubashara, those 10 individuals who were granted the ijaza or granted the glad tidings of paradise in this very dunya. Subhanallah. So alhamdulillah, we learned some beautiful and important matters today, dear viewers of Madani channel. Alhamdulillah. Kash we do not disrespect any companion of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Kash we could be obedient to them and love them as they possessed love and respect for one another. If you have to only study and learn about what Mawla Ali radiyallahu anhu says about Siddiqi Akbar, what he radiyallahu anhu says about Hazrat Sayyidina Umar Farooq and Uthman Ghani, it is really amazing. Subhanallah, the amount of respect and adab they shown to one another. Today we are fighting about superiority. Today we are arguing because shaitan, iblis comes and puts waswasa in the minds and corrupts our belief. Allahu Akbar. And then we miss the true path, deviate from the righteous path, and then we commit many other sins openly after we become blunt like that. So it's very important for us to understand what the love of Sayyidina Ali radiyallahu anhu demands. It's very important for us to understand the true ranking, the right ranking, and the superiority of one another above each another, who has been given what ranking. And from there, inshallah, you can pass this message to others as well. Strengthen your iman and the faith and iman of others as well, for the pleasure of Allah Azza wa Jalla. Love all the companions, love the Ahlul Bayt of the Holy Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam unconditionally. Love them and follow the footsteps of the Ahlul Bayt. It is extremely important for us to be on the righteous path, inshallah. Stay locked and tuned with Madani channel. Until tomorrow, stay good, be good, do good. And remember, wherever you are, I must strive to reform myself and the people of the entire world. Inshallah Azza wa Jal. Sallu ala al-Habib sallallahu ala Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
Start your day with remembrance.